All right, folks, this is a Oklahoma weather alert here just before 7 o'clock, and it's William Cole here live at the Oklahoma Weather Tracker TV Forecast Center. And we continue to track severe weather across parts of eastern Oklahoma. A live mesoscan radar here. First of all the counties in blue, this is a severe thunderstorm watch that's in effect in Oklahoma until midnight tonight. And again, you can see severe weather now focusing down across parts of southern and southeastern Oklahoma. Lead storm tracker Philip McGee is down there. We're going to be checking in with him coming up here in just a second. But we are really paying close attention to this storm now in parts of Atoka County. This is just to the west of Atoka. And again, this storm right here, it does have a history of producing tennis ball size hail earlier when it was right over the town of Tishomingo. Continues to track east here at 45 miles per hour. Still a very large hail core wrapped up there. And again, that's going to travel directly over the Atoka area and also Tushika. Down there as well, just to the south of Atoka. And again, this is a quite severe storm. I do want to go back to Philip McGee's live stream because, again, this storm, it has had some weak rotation with it. Again, not to alarm anybody, we're not saying it's going to produce a tornado, but it has had an intermittent wall cloud. And again, Philip McGee and Mark Rodriguez, they've been down there on that storm. And let me go and pull Philip McGee on the live line here with us. And Philip, tell us what you're seeing down there right now and kind of bring us up to date. Again, you're looking at this storm there directly.
Yeah, William, we're going to probably have to relocate. We're right in the middle of the rotation at this moment. We pulled up one of the better roads called Park Lane, and we're just outside of the town of Caddo up to the northwest, and we are looking to the northwest as that rotation is starting to move across that area. We're into the rain right now. The hail core is just to the north of us, just by a little ways, but we're at pretty much right in the middle of the circulation. It is a broad circulation right now, but as we were making our way over here, it was tightened up pretty tight. There was very defined wall clouds, and on the southern ends of it, we had also seen some brief frontal clouds, nothing that connected to the ground by any means, but there were two frontal clouds that came out of the storm and then rapidly went right back up into it, and it kind of fell apart a little bit. So it's going through a three-side change right now, and we're going to get back over to a better road and reposition so that we can still stream this live for the folks. Back to you.
All right, Philip, really appreciate that right there, that update. And again, as we're looking at Philip McGee's stream, we're going to go back to radar here in a second. So Philip, it looks like as we're kind of looking at your shot here, so as we're taking a look at it here, if from your angle, if we're taking a look at the left, so from Philip's angle to the left, the left hand side, is that kind of the edge of the mesocyclone? Is that what we're seeing right there in your shot? So as we're looking at it from your angle, we're looking off directly to the west there, to the left of your side there, is that the edge of the mesocyclone? Is that what we're looking at?
Looking at the left side of the mesocyclone, and the rotation was directly in front of us. We're relocating at the moment. Back to you.
All right, Philip, appreciate that. So let's switch back over to radar. So, and again, there's no tornado warning on this storm. Again, we don't want to alarm anybody. But again, this storm does have a history of, again, some weak rotation with it. It has had a wall cloud with it now over about the last 30 minutes or so. And what this kind of broad rotation, if you will, is doing, it's actually maximizing this hail core. This is a big hail core that, again, is coming right into Atoka and also Tushika down there as well. And again, this storm does have a history of producing some tennis ball size hail that is damaging, that is destructive hail. And again, that is now tracking eastbound directly into the Atoka area right there for our friends in Atoka. Also still some heavier activity still back over near the Tishomingo area. These are strong storms, not severe, but again, this storm right here, again, is quite severe. Now let's go and pull the radar out here just a little bit, and we'll take a look across the rest of Oklahoma. Philip McGee, he's repositioning, so we're going to check back in with him coming up here momentarily. This other storm up here in Hughes County, this is also severe. And again, you can see basically the severe core there directly over really the Calvin area, moving through Calvin right now, and then also just to the south of the Lamar area there as well. And again, there was a severe thunderstorm warning that again does continue on that cell right there as well. And then as we zoom out the radar across parts of Cole County, right over Colgate, again, a fairly heavy storm moving through there. Again, that storm right there is non-severe. But again, folks, I'll tell you, the most severe storm that we currently have in the state, it is this storm just to the west of the Atoka area. And again, that's the storm that Philip McGee is on currently right now. As we zoom this back in, again, like we mentioned, the storm, it has had at least some broad rotation with it. It has had a wall cloud from time to time. No signals that it's anywhere near close to producing a tornado, nothing like that. But again, like I was mentioning, a lot of times when these storms do get some broad rotation, the one thing that it does, it maximizes the hail core. And that's exactly what we're seeing with this. We're seeing that dark red going to purple. That's a large hail core right there. And again, this storm does have a history of producing, again, some tennis ball size hail earlier, as it was really over the town of Tishomingo. So again, for Atoka, back down here through Toshika, again, heads up, this is a quite severe storm. And again, keep in mind, when we're talking about tennis ball size hail, again, that is very damaging hail, not only for your car, but also for your roofs. And again, with depending on you know, where your house is, the angle of it, it can also blow out some windows too, again, with some of those 65 mile per hour plus straight line winds. Again, so definitely keep that in mind. This is the most severe storm currently in the state. Now, I want to go back to Philip McGee. He's on that storm again. He's looking to the north at it. He's having to reposition just a little bit with this storm, but I want to go ahead and bring him back on the line. Philip, I see your stream. I see you're still moving there, but let me go and bring you back on the line. Give us an update as to what you're seeing right now with this storm. You're just on the southern sides of it. Again, you have seen at least a little bit of broad rotation from time to time. Tell us what you're seeing right now.
Okay, William, yeah, we're looking back to the northwest as we're trying to reposition. We're just a few miles from Highway 69, and we'll be able to take and shoot back to the northwest again. But on the back side of the storm, there's a lowering on the back side of it, and a little bit of RFB is what we can tell, with some rain coming on the back side also. So, anyway, again, like we said, this is not a tornado-worn storm, but it's definitely something that we need to keep our eye on, and that's why we're out right now. So it's very looking, that's why we're here. We're going to bring this to the folks live here in just a second. Back to you, William.
Absolutely, Philip. And again, Philip there is driving around. Of course, he's there with Mark Rodriguez, is also with him today as well. So they're kind of repositioning. It looks like his stream maybe froze just momentarily there, but we're going to get back to his stream. He's about to turn back to the north, and then we'll be back in prime position to see that storm. But I tell you what, folks, again, this storm, it is quite severe. And again, like I said, it does have a history of producing that tennis ball size hail. And I honestly think it's quite capable of doing it right now as well. As we're looking at this hail core, again, that purple going to white right there. Again, more than likely, there's still some tennis ball size hail falling out of that. And again, that is quite damaging hail there as well. You can see Philip McGee's live GPS location as, again, he's just, again, navigating around that storm. Some of the roads back there, of course, across parts of eastern Oklahoma and western Atoka County there, it gets fairly rural. So again, he's kind of having to navigate, again, some of those country roads, if you will. But let's go ahead and zoom the radar out here. Let's go and take more of an overview again here. And as we do that, let's go and take a look here across parts of east central Oklahoma. Severe thunderstorm warning continues here for Hughes County. Again, that storm just on the southern sides of Horntown there. Again, you can see a hail core just south of Horntown, and then also a fairly intense part of that storm there as well, just to the north of Lamar. But again, the hail core there focusing just on the southern sides of Horntown. Quarter size hail possible with that storm right there. We're going to check back in with Philip McGee because it looks like he's repositioning. He's getting us a better look at, again, some of the dynamics that are happening with that other storm. So let's go back to Philip's stream. And Philip, you're back on the live line here with us. Go ahead and bring us up to date. I saw you're just kind of repositioning there. We're going to kickstart your stream from here, and we'll get it back up and going. But go and tell us kind of what you're seeing as you're repositioning there on that storm. Again, you know, tennis ball size hail, that's been the history with that storm. You're looking at it right now. Again, what are you seeing? And again, what about, again, that lowering that you were talking about a few minutes ago as well?
Yeah, William, that lowering is actually, it looks like the storm is trying to recycle. We're looking back to the west. We're seeing another area back to the south end of that original storm, and that's what these kind of do. They'll kind of build up on the south end of it, but we're seeing another actual area of concern that has some rapid rising motion in it there on the back side. So, you know, that's like you just said, it's going to maximize those hail cores right now. This is not a tornado-worn storm, but it's definitely, definitely something that we need to keep our eyes on.
Yeah, absolutely, Philip. There's no doubt about it. You're doing a great job, and you can tell Philip really having to navigate some of those more rural roads down there. It looks like he's probably on an unpaved road. road right now. Again, you can kind of tell, again, by the camera shaking around there. Yeah, it looks like he might even be on a dirt road there. So again, this is a storm that we're talking about, folks. This is the strongest storm in the state. It is still quite severe. And again, it's a storm just to the west of Atoka, just to the west of Toshika there. And again, this does have a history of producing some tennis ball size hail, could still be producing some tennis ball size hail. And again, like I mentioned, that is quite damaging hail. You can see Phillip's live GPS location. He's navigating. Again, he's shooting back up to the north. And again, this storm, it has had a history of producing a couple wall clouds, nowhere near producing a tornado, nothing like that. But again, some of that rotation within the storm, some of that broad rotation, if you will, what it does, it actually helps to suspend the hail in the air. And so the hail only gets bigger the longer it stays in the air before it finally drops out. And that's what we're seeing here with this really maximized hail core, with a little bit of that broad rotation happening right there with that storm as well. So we're going to check back in with Phillip here momentarily. And before we do that, before we get back to him, I'm just looking at his stream there to see what he's seeing in his stream. And Phillip, if you have anything, just feel free to tell me. And so this other storm is actually fairly strong over just to the east of Tishomingo. Let's take a look at this one here. And Tishomingo, you folks down there got hit with some of that tennis ball size hail earlier. And again, that is damaging hail. So most likely there's some cars that have been damaged, and there maybe were even a couple windows blown out around the Tishomingo area. Again, as that tennis ball size hail moved through probably about an hour ago now. But again, looking off to the east there, still a bit of a heavy thunderstorm there, non-severe, but between Tishomingo and Milburn, again, where you're seeing that dark red going to purple, again, that's a quite intense storm, if you will. A lot of cloud of ground lightning with that one, but again, that specific cell there is, again, non-severe. So that's good news with that right there. As we zoom back out, our only other severe storm is actually up here across parts of Hughes County, and our storm tracker, Derek James, he's on that one. You can see his live GPS location. We're going to be checking in with Derek coming up here momentarily. Again, he's on that storm there. But again, just really to the east of Horntown now, and now actually approaching the Lamar area. Let me go and move the radar around, and let's actually zoom that out just a little bit. And so again, this one here is severe as well. And again, an opportunity for some quarter size hail with this storm. And again, you can see exactly where that hail core is right there between Horntown, between Lamar. There's DJ, there's Derek James' live GPS location. But again, that storm right there, quarter size hail quite possible with that, and again, winds over 60 miles per hour as well. So let's zoom out. Let's go a little bit further to the north up along the I-40 corridor there. And again, you can also see another at least heavier thunderstorm now just on the southern sides of I-40. And again, that's going to pass really just to the east of Henrietta, very close to the Pierce area that will cross directly over I-40. Again, that's a non-severe storm, but it is quite heavy. It will produce some brief heavy rain, some cloud of ground lightning with that one right there for sure as well. So that cloud of ground lightning, of course, is always a big concern. But again, as we get back further to the south, these are where, again, our severe storms are. And in fact, the way it looks right now, that one storm to the east of Tishomingo, it's now gone severe as well. Let me go ahead and check that warning here real quick. And again, a brand new severe thunderstorm warning on that storm there, and it's going to be until 8 o'clock. And again, that's going to be for Johnston and Atoka County. And again, that's going to be at least the opportunity for some quarter size hail. And again, so we have really two severe storms down here. Again, this one right here, again, just to the east of the Tishomingo area, Johnston County and Atoka County. Again, severe thunderstorm warning until 8 p.m. as that does continue to track off to the east. Quarters likely with that storm moving right through the Milburn area right now. Luckily, that's smaller than the tennis ball size hail that moved through earlier with this storm over here. But again, quarters quite likely now moving directly through the Milburn area there in Johnston County. And then our other storm that again is quite a bit stronger, if you will, that is basically moving right through the Atoka area right now. Let me go and check that one here real quick as well. And again, so that one's moving directly over the Atoka area. That's also the one that lead storm tracker Phillip McGee is on. We're going to check back in with him here in a minute. But again, this is a very significant hail core, folks. When you're looking at radar here, when you're seeing that purple going to white right there between Toshika and almost focusing directly over Atoka now, unfortunately, that is probably still some tennis ball size hail. Let's go to Phillip McGee's live stream. And Phillip, looks like you've got just a little something going on there, kind of on the back end of that storm. And again, you can basically see where the rain curtains are. And then also you can see just some of the updraft motion into the storm there on the back end. But Phillip, you're on the live line. Let me go and pull your stream up here as well. Go ahead and give us an update with what you're seeing there on that storm.
Yeah, absolutely, William. That's exactly what we were talking about just a second ago. You can see that backside cloud. You can see the rotation. It's not a tight rotation, but you can definitely see the uplifting motion of this mesocyclone as it moves across basically Highway 75 over towards Tuscaloosa right now. Actually, as we're sitting here, it looks like that it's starting to pick up a little bit more in that uplifting rapid motion. But we're going to keep you guys posted on this.
Hey, Philip, tell me real quick, where exactly is that? So as you're looking at that, folks, what we're looking at here, we're looking at lifting upward motion. So here's the rain curtains. That's where the rain's falling right back over in here. This is the back end of the storm right here. We've got some rising motion. You can see a little bit of that condensate kind of wrapping up in there, a little bit of rising motion with that storm right there. Again, this is fairly common. This is a supercell storm. There's no doubt this is a supercell. Not all supercells produce tornadoes. This storm, you know, chances are may not produce a tornado. There's no tornado warning on it. But again, a lot of times you will get some dynamics, you will get a mesocyclone, and that's basically what we have developing with this storm. So there's a lot of different dynamics going on that, of course, we're keeping an eye on. But Philip, go ahead and tell us exactly where you are. So as you're looking at this storm, go ahead and give us your position, and again, kind of give us a, just kind of geographically where you are as you're looking at that storm there.
Okay, William, we are just north of Caddo and just south of Tuscaloosa, Oklahoma, and we're looking back to the northwest. And that main cell is going to be moving right across Highway 75 here in just a matter of just a couple of minutes.
Okay, Philip. Yeah, absolutely. I'm just looking at radar there while you were talking as well. So there's still some very broad rotation. And again, like we've said here a couple times, a lot of times what that broad rotation does, again, it kind of basically it maximizes those hail cores. It makes the hail cores really intense. And I'm going to break away from your live shot for just a second, Philip. I want you to go and stay on the live line there with us. But again, what we're talking about when I say maximized hail core, look at this hail core. Look how, unfortunately, how impressive this is. I mean, it's unfortunate because it's moving through Atoka right now, and chances are there is tennis ball size hail falling in here. It's because there's broad rotation, and that broad rotation is suspending that hail in the air. It's not falling down as quick as it normally would, so it's getting bigger and bigger and bigger before it finally falls, and that's what's happening. This is a maximized hail core moving directly over Atoka, tennis ball size hail likely right there with that storm. And again, it all has to do with the dynamics and a little bit of that rotation that's happening with that storm. As we go back to Philip McGee's live shot, again, now we're looking more or less kind of at the rain curtains, the bulk of the storm, the rain and the hail there directly in front of them. But Philip, go ahead and give us an update, kind of give us a play-by-play of what you're seeing there on that storm live.
Okay, William, yeah, we left the present location that we were at. We were parked in a parking lot, like I said, between Caddo and Atoka. There's a lot of cloud to ground lightning. You'll be able to see that at the stream here in just a second. But like you were saying, that upward rotation and everything else is only maximizing that hail core. Like you said, wouldn't doubt it one bit if there was not tennis ball size hail in that main core of the storm. It's a scary looking storm. You know, we have seen some pretty tight circulation at some point on our way over to get on this thing. But like I said, you know, I want folks to understand this is not a tornado warning storm. And so we've got it, you know, we've got it covered. We're down here. We're taking a close look at it. And so back to you.
Okay, Philip, absolutely appreciate that. So yeah, Philip's eyes are on that storm for sure. I mean, he's got it covered right there. Anything that would happen with it, of course, we would bring it to you live right here on Oklahoma Weather Tracker TV. But the main takeaway from the storm is, folks, it is the extremely damaging hail, unfortunately, again, that is moving directly through the Atoka area. So we're going to put on just a different presentation on radar here real quick. I'm going to switch away from the shot for just 1 second, and we're going to go ahead and take a look at live mesoscan radar. And as we switch over here, again, when we're talking about broad rotation, you'll sometimes hear broad rotation and then you'll hear tight rotation. When you hear tight rotation, that normally means tornado, and that means really bad deal. When you hear broad rotation, that means a lot of times the storm itself is actually spinning. And like I mentioned, it'll suspend that hail in the air. And again, it makes the hail get bigger and bigger and bigger until it finally falls to the ground. That's why we're getting that tennis ball size hail. But as you're looking at velocities here on the radar, again, you're seeing the red, you're seeing the green. It's all kind of coming together here. This is that real broad rotation. So again, no tornado imminent, no lowerings, nothing like that. But again, this broad rotation, again, that's what's maximizing that hail core and focusing it, again, right over the Atoka area. So when we're saying broad rotation, that's basically what we're talking about right there. Now, if we're saying tight rotation, that's when the dynamics are changing and things get a little more serious in the form of, again, tornado potential with the storm. But again, right now, there's really no tornado potential with this storm. It's just rotating. And again, there's a lot of dynamics going on with it. And again, right now, it is just a big time hail producer. And again, again, that hail, unfortunately, is basically hammering Atoka right now with some tennis ball size hail likely falling over the town of Atoka right now. So let's check back in with Philip McGee again. He's still looking at this storm live. He's got eyes on it. We're going to switch back to his live stream here. And Philip, again, go ahead and bring us up to date. You're getting a little bit closer, it looks like, to that storm now, kind of on the back end. You're coming right up into the middle of it there. And give us an update with what you're seeing on it.
Okay, well, yeah, absolutely. As a matter of fact, we're actually getting relatively close to that hail core that you talked about. As a matter of fact, it's going to be showing up on our screen here in just a second. You can kind of see that area of lower...
Hey, Philip, hey, just one thing, just to interrupt you, just real quick. I hate to interrupt you, but just make sure don't get in that hail core, because, again, with those tennis balls, it'll blow your window out, and you guys will be dead in the water down there. So that hail core will most likely blow your windshield out. So don't get up in the hail core. I would still stay back from it just a little bit, again, because we don't want you guys, you know, dead in the water, so to speak, down there. We want to, you know, continue with this. But that hail core is absolutely, no doubt about it, it's damaging, and it's most likely still producing some tennis balls down there. So just a word of caution there for you.
Yeah, absolutely. No, we're going to actually pull over up here in just a second. We want to be able to give folks a good shot of this. We're looking for a main access road off to the south here in just a second. We're going to kind of stream back to the north and west again at basically what we're looking at. Like I said, it's a pretty ominous-looking cloud and a very ominous-looking storm, period. And so, you know, we said that you need to take your precautions to prepare for the hail and everything else. And so until we can get up here onto this main road, I want to hand it back to you, buddy.
All right, Philip, I really appreciate that update there. And again, Philip McGee, again, doing a great job on that storm down there. This is the most severe storm in the state, but let's go ahead and talk about the rest of these storms as well. I'm going to switch away from Philip McGee's live shot for 1 second. And unfortunately, again, with live mesoscan radar, you can see that potential tennis ball size hail core is still over Atoka. It's been really sitting over Atoka for really about the last 10 minutes. So this is really maximum impact for them. And again, if we are truly still getting some tennis balls out of that cell, again, probably some damage is likely in Atoka, maybe some windows blown out, definitely probably some cars damaged, unfortunately, with that tennis ball size hail. Now, this storm down here has come up quickly as well. This one's coming up quick. This one just went severe probably about 15 minutes ago, but it's coming up quick and it's got a fairly big hail core with it now as well. And so let's go and take a look at this one as well. That one's actually coming up over the Coleman area. That's eastern Johnson County down there. And again, severe thunderstorm warning continues on that until 8 p.m. this evening. But there is a definite hail core there as well. Quarters plus probably likely, probably more like golf balls now coming into the Coleman area there with 65 mile per hour plus straight line winds possible with that core there as well. Again, that one is quite severe too. And again, so we're going to check that. Our other storm tracker, Josh Holcomb, is just to the south of that. We'll be checking in with Josh coming up here momentarily. Let's go ahead and zoom the radar out here just a little bit. And as we do that, we'll give you an overview. We don't want to forget about the rest of the state. But again, the only two severe thunderstorm warnings we currently have are there in southern Oklahoma. Again, that's the storm that Philip McGee is currently on. Again, our other storm trackers scattered around the state. We'll check in with Josh Holcomb coming up in a minute. But across parts of northern, let's say, Hughes and Pittsburgh County, just to the north and to the west of the McAllister area, these are heavier thunderstorms. And in fact, they were severe warned earlier. And again, you can still see some dark red, a little bit of purple showing up there. And again, there's still an opportunity for probably some dime size hail out of these storms here. So these are still quite heavy. We don't want to forget about those. They're non-severe, but again, quite heavy storms. They continue to lift off to the northeast. They're going to cross I-40. So again, from Lake Eufaula, Shakota, really just to the north of the McAllister, all northern Pittsburgh County. Again, heads up, again, non-severe storms, but again, quite heavy, as again, those do continue to lift off to the northeast. Dimes likely, and also very, very electrically active storms. A lot of cloud to ground lightning with those as well. And again, these are the main two severe storms down there across parts of southern Oklahoma. And again, those storms are quite severe. Let's zoom back in on those. And as we do that, again, lead storm tracker Philip McGee, he's down there on those storms. And I tell you what, folks, that storm right there just to the west of Coleman, it is really coming up. In fact, the one just now to the east of Atoka, it's actually cycling down a little bit, which is good. This is the one here that has had the history of producing confirmed tennis ball size hail. Most likely tennis ball size hail went through the Atoka area there, unfortunately. But again, as we look off to the east now, this storm down here near Coleman, really on the southern flank of this storm, on the back end of it, if you will, it is really now cranking up, and some golf ball plus size hail would definitely be possible with that storm. You're seeing the purple going to white, golf balls plus possible now moving into the Coleman area right there for sure. Philip McGee also has eyes on that storm as well. I know he's repositioning down there. And we're going to take his live stream back again here momentarily as well. But Philip, I tell you what, that other storm back there just to your west, it's really coming up now. It's coming up big time, and it's moving right through the Coleman area. The other storm, I think, off to your north and to your east that moved through Atoka, I think that's kind of cycling right now. It's going through a cycling phase. But again, you're down there. You have your eyes on it. We're going to switch back to your stream. And tell us what you're seeing with those storms, as again, you're really kind of splitting the hair. You're in between both of them down there right now live.
Yeah, that's right, William. We pulled over here to give the folks, a good shot of that pour that's moving across the Atoka area right now. As we were looking, we were just looking up at the clouds, kind of getting some ideas about what the motion was doing. And there's some areas of intermittent circulation, nothing to be concerned about. But we're definitely, like you said, we're keeping an eye on that one that's down to the south of us because it really has picked up. We're looking at it from behind now. And we're in a pretty decent position right now that storm should maybe just move just to the north and west of us also. So we're in a relatively decent place where we can take and keep an eye on this thing.
Absolutely, Philip. And so I'm going to switch back to radar here just real quick from your shot. So again, this is where Philip is. This is his live GPS location right there. So again, he's splitting both of these storms. He's looking off to the north, but he's also keeping an eye on this storm right here that again has the history of producing the tennis ball size hail. It's cycled down a little bit, folks, but you can see here with the latest radar scan, again, that purple and that white coloring here and the reflectivity, it started to pick back up. So again, this storm is definitely not going away. It's actually picked back up. These storms, they cycle up and they cycle down, and that's exactly what we're seeing with that one there. And now this other storm down here, like I mentioned, it has really come up here now over the last 30 minutes. It went from really a heavier thunderstorm we were watching as it went right over Tishomingo to really now flaring up there across parts of the Coleman area. I would probably say golf balls plus likely with that storm right there. And again, it is quite severe, continuing to track off to the east and also to the northeast as well. So again, Philip McGee in prime time location there, keeping an eye on both of those storms. These are the only two severe storms in the state. Again, we have other storms in the state. They're only heavy, they're non-severe, so that's good news right there that again we only currently have two severe storms in the state. Let's go back to the broad view here real quick, and then Philip, we're going to get back to you here momentarily as well. And if you have anything to add, just let me know so we can get right back to your shot. But let's go and take a look at the broad view just so everyone can kind of see the overview of what's going on here. And as we pull that up, so as we take a look at the overview, again, severe thunderstorm watch continues until midnight for Oklahoma, all these counties in blue here across eastern Oklahoma, severe thunderstorm watch until midnight. What we're going to see evolve here over the next several hours is these individual cells are all going to kind of line up along the dry line. We're going to see a line of thunderstorms develop and push east as we head into the overnight period. Now again, the only two severe thunderstorm warnings we currently have are down here across parts of southern Oklahoma. All the other activity you saw there, again, that's just in the way of some heavier thunderstorms currently. So that's good news in regards to the fact we only have two severe thunderstorm warnings when we have this entire severe thunderstorm watch. So that part right there is good. But again, Philip McGee, he's down there, again, on those severe thunderstorms. So let's go and switch back over here. And we'll zoom back in on that activity down there in southern Oklahoma here, first of all, to the activity that is severe. And we'll get back to Philip here on the live line. But again, both of these storms down there in southern Oklahoma, these are both hailers. And these are big-time hail producers. And again, the one now that's east of Atoka, again, that's had the history of producing some tennis ball-sized hail. And even that storm now that's just to the north and just to the east of Coleman, that one potentially, folks, could be producing some golf ball plus size hail. These are big time hail producers. And again, also some wind, 65, 70 miles per hour plus, that could create some blowing hail. It could blow out some windows. And again, keep in mind that tennis ball size hail could definitely damage some cars as well. So let's do this. Let's go and get Philip McGee back on the live line here. Philip, we're going to take your live stream again momentarily as well. But you're looking at both of these storms. You're actually in between both of them right now live. Give us an update as to what you're seeing on both of those storms there specifically. Okay.
Okay, yeah, William. We're still on the southern end of this storm there at Atoka. But as you can tell in the stream, we had another developing like wall clouds to the south end of that. You can see from the stream that the motion, although it's not all that great, you can see the lifting and the turning of that being lifted up into that storm there directly in front of us.
Hey, Philip, you may check your stream real quick. It looks like from here, it looks like it is frozen from here, actually. Yeah, your stream is frozen. So you may just double check that. And just so we can go ahead and kick that back in, because we'd definitely like to see what you're seeing there. These storms are very dynamic, folks. These have had a lot of what we call broad rotation, no tight rotation, nowhere near producing a tornado. But again, they have had some broad rotation. These are supercells. They have a mesocyclone. So again, those do produce rotation. And as that happens a lot of times, it will produce very large hail. And that's what we've seen. We've seen these maximized hail cores today. And again, it all has to do with that very broad rotation with these storms. Philip, we still have your stream up there. You may want to go and kickstart that and get it going. If not, we'll go and switch off of it. But right now, it still looks like it's frozen. But again, we've seen some fairly dynamic video from Philip this evening with some of the rising motion and just some of the dynamics with these storms as we've gone through the evening. And again, that's exactly what he's talking about right now with the dynamics, with the rising motion. And again, like I mentioned, that all has to do with, again, that opportunity to really produce some big hail out of these storms. Now, Philip, it looks like your stream's coming back up, so let's go and switch over here and go ahead and give us an update as to what you're seeing. So it looks like you might have a little inflow feeder band there on the back end of that storm. Now, are you looking at, as we take a look at your live stream there, are you looking at that storm now that's just east of Atoka, or which storm are you looking at there? That's an inflow band. That's warm air feeding into the storm there, what we're seeing there.
Uplifting motion going into that storm right now. You can see the scud clouds developing and being sucked up into that updraft. And it was more of a pronounced wall cloud just a few minutes ago on the southern end of this. But to be quite honest with you, I mean, it was pretty impressive there for just a second. And then it kind of fell apart, but it looks like to me that it's probably getting it back together again. And starting to get some of that rotation back to it, which again is only going to magnify that hail core. So back to you.
Hey, Philip, and tell us exactly where you are now. Go ahead and give us your exact location. So we're looking at this storm. Again, this storm is, it's now east of Atoka. It's really between, or really just to the south of Stringtown. Let me go and pull up radar again here real quick, just to give everybody an idea of what we're talking about. And again, Philip, you're talking about this storm over here. So this one here, south of Stringtown. Again, this has been the fairly dynamic storm today with this broad rotation, not tight rotation in order to actually produce a tornado, but a real broad rotation that's creating these really big hail cores. And again, basically the video that we're seeing from Philip McGee, this is a true mesocyclone. This storm is actually feeding in some warm air. As we go back over to Philip McGee's live shot, and Philip, can I don't know if you can maybe zoom that out just a little bit. You're fairly tight there. You're real tight. If you can zoom that out, and again, what we're seeing are just some of these cloud features, and it all has to do with this really living, breathing storm. And again, really the tail that we saw there just a second ago, that was basically some warm air feeding into the storm. It looks like that's kind of gone away right now with some of the condensate. But again, as we're continuing to take a look at the storm right now, again, no pending tornado, nothing like that. I know sometimes when you hear rotation, mesocyclone, that's the first thing you think of. But again, this is just a supercell that's producing some big hail. And again, it is a supercell. And again, it has had some fairly dynamic features as we've gone throughout the evening. Now, again, really that inflow tail there has basically gone away, Philip. We've kind of seen it kind of evaporate there directly in front of us. But go ahead and bring us up to date. You're still kind of looking at it there, eyes on it. Go ahead and kind of give us a play-by-play of what you're seeing there with that, again, supercell now just to the east of the Atoka area.
Yeah, as we've been down on this storm, we've kind of watched the cycle two or three different times. There'll be different areas of circulation that pick up, just maximizing that hail core. Right now, we're watching just an area of movement, of circulation, and it just to the back side of that one feeder band that we were just talking about just a second ago. That one area that we were showing on the stream has basically, like you said, has gone away. It's moved to the southern end of that storm now. And as far as location-wise, you're absolutely right. It's going to be probably around Stringtown area, just south or just east of Atoka.
Okay, Philip McGee, really appreciate that update right there. So again, I mean, Philip McGee continues with eyes on that storm right there. And again, you're basically seeing, again, this living, breathing storm right there. And again, the cloud formations change with it. Again, there has been some broad rotation, nowhere near producing a tornado. We just want to keep putting an asterisk on that, because again, a lot of times when people hear, again, rotation, that's the first thing they think of. But again, this is a supercell. It does have rotation. And basically, this is a supercell that's been producing extremely large hail, extremely damaging hail, with a history of some tennis ball size hail here. again, really over the last hour or so, specifically as it moved directly over the town of Atoka for about 10 to 15 minutes, sat over Atoka, and then also as it moved through Tishomingo a little earlier today as well. So we're still taking a live look at this. This is Philip McGee's live stream there. And again, this storm, it's just to the south of Stringtown. It's now to the east of Atoka. And again, of course, as daylight is now kind of starting to fall there, but we're still got a pretty good, we still got enough lighting there that we can take a pretty good look at this storm here. And again, what we saw a minute ago was basically just an inflow feeder band, just some warm air feeding into the storm. And again, these things will evolve. They'll kind of form those and they'll kind of go away with the condensate. And that's, again, basically what we're seeing. And all that warm air is doing, it's just feeding the storm. And again, it's helping making that that hail core, again, basically maintaining it or even potentially making it a little bit bigger there as well. So Philip, what town? It looks like you're driving through a town there. Tell us what town. I mean, you're to the south of Stringtown. So what town are you driving through right there?
That's right, William. We're headed eastbound out of Stringtown, and we're going to stay along the side of this storm as it moves off to the north and east. So, you know, we're keeping a close eye on this thing as it moves up toward. Hold on 1 second here.
It's going to be moving up towards the Stringtown and up towards the Redden area.
Right, right, absolutely. And so we're going to parallel that storm and just follow it and keep an eye on it. But like you said, you know, those feeder bands and everything else are basically just, you know, they're living, breathing storms, and they have to have that warm, moist air in order to survive, and that's what they're doing. They're tracking right along that, drawing all that moisture in, and then just maximizing those hail cores. We talked to some individuals who said that they had just experienced some high winds and damaging hail. As they were driving through.
How big was the hail, Philip? Did it tell you how big the hail was?
Did they say how big the hail was? No, they did not say how big the hail was. They just said large hail, and so they were worried about whether they could make it further south. And so we let them know, you know, that there was another cell that was approaching from that area, and so they probably should just stay put until this one's actually made it through.
Okay, let's go and do this. We're going to take a look at these cells up across northern Oklahoma because we actually have a couple new severe thunderstorm warnings up there. Actually, one severe thunderstorm warning for a couple different counties. But let's go and pull out the radar and let's go north up here. And this is going to be up here near the Muskogee area, also near Wagner as well. Let's go and zoom the radar in here a little bit. And these are going to be brand new severe thunderstorm warnings. This is going to be for McIntosh, Cherokee, Wagner, and Muskogee County until 8:15 this evening. 60-mile-per-hour winds and quarter-size hail possible. Again, with this storm right here, it's basically going to move right up between really Taft and could potentially even move right over the Muskogee area. So again, you can see where the hail core is. I probably don't have to tell you where you're seeing the purple and the pink right there. Again, this is a hail core right there. And again, quarters quite likely, 60-plus-mile-per-hour winds. This is going to track to the northeast, again, really between Taft and really as far east as Muskogee as well. Summit right there as well, tracking up towards the OK area, also over towards Fort Gibson as well. Wagner right up in there. Of course, here's the Tulsa Metro right over in there. So again, this is a brand new severe thunderstorm warning until 8:15 with this storm. And again, for our friends up there in the Muskogee area, again, definitely a heads up as this is heading in with some quarter size hail and again, winds 60 miles per hour plus, quite possible with that storm. So that's a brand new severe thunderstorm warning. Let's zoom this out here just a little bit. Let's kind of give an overview here again. I know as we cover a lot of different places around Oklahoma, sometimes it's kind of hard to keep everything straight. But again, what we have is we have that one lone severe thunderstorm warning up there and across parts of northeastern Oklahoma, the new one there, until 8:15 this evening. Then we also have these other severe thunderstorm warnings down here until 8 p.m. across parts of southern Oklahoma. That's where Philip McGee is. That's also where Josh Holcomb is. That's where our team of trackers are. And again, we're going to get back down there to them and get the very latest because we've been tracking this fairly intense storm down across parts of southern Oklahoma here really over about the last hour or so. And let's switch back over here. And Philip McGee has now gone into night scope mode. This is really exclusive here to Oklahoma Weather Tracker TV. Philip McGee and the Oklahoma Customs official storm tracking truck, he's now gone into night scope mode. And this is important, folks, because especially when we're tracking storms after dark, you don't see this anywhere else in Oklahoma. You may not see this anywhere else in the country, to be really honest with you, at least live when we're talking about tracking storms live. But again, this is what Philip McGee's Oklahoma Customs official storm tracking truck is set up with. But I mean, look at that. Look at the resolution with that. Again, we can see basically exactly what's going on even as the light continues to fall out there. So again, really a high resolution night scope view there from Philip McGee. So we're going to check back in with him momentarily. And as we switch the radar back over, let's go and zoom back in here to parts of southern Oklahoma. And again, these are our two severe storms that do continue down here. And again, the one severe storm, unfortunately, it's actually coming right back over the Atoka area. Atoka, you folks just had a severe storm about 30 minutes ago that potentially produced some tennis ball size hail as it moved through. You have another severe storm moving through basically right now as well. Some quarter to golf ball size hail is going to be likely with this cell right here, as again, really round two in like the last 30 minutes, it's happening right now for Atoka. This is going to track right up through the Atoka area. And then again, we have that other storm there just to the east of Atoka. This has been the big hail producer. This one has been the one that has produced that tennis ball size hail as we've gone throughout the evening. And again, you can still see that purple going to white. It's still got that really mean looking hail core with it. And again, that's going to be moving right up through the Redden area. That's also the storm that's had some broad rotation. Again, nowhere near producing a tornado, but again, with that broad rotation, that spin motion with the storm, it holds that hail up as long as it can before it finally drops it down with that rotation. And again, that's what's producing that really big hail. And again, that's why this one has such a mean looking hail core. And again, that's why it's had some tennis ball size hail. But that is tracking directly up there towards the Redden area. Severe thunderstorm warning continues on that right there as well. So let's go back to Philip McGee. He's still in night scope mode. And let's get an update from him because he's taking a look at that storm there tracking up towards Redden. Philip, you're on the live line with us. Go ahead and bring us up to date.
Yeah, absolutely, William. We noticed the same thing, and that cloud is actually pretty ominous back there to the south and west of us that's moving through that Redden area. And like you said, unfortunately, it's training over the same area that it just passed through. So we're going to be here, as you can tell in the stream, there's a lot of cloud-to-ground lightning associated with that. And so we're going to keep our eyes on this one as we notice some interesting features that we need to kind of hang back and keep an eye on. So I want to hand it back to you.
Hey, Philip, and again, so you're looking at that storm just directly south of Redden, is that correct? And so that's a storm. It's kind of cycled up and down just a little bit. And again, you can still see some of those little low-hanging clouds with it. And again, for some people, of course, when you see that, that does look a little scary. And keep in mind, Philip McGee, he's in night scope mode. So even though this looks kind of black and white as the sun is now setting, as the daylight is basically going away, this night scope mode here exclusively you're seeing on Oklahoma Weather Tracker TV. Again, even at night, we can see exactly what's going on. Look at all that cloud of ground lightning we're seeing. All that's how electrically active these storms are. That's the first thing I noticed there. So again, keep in mind, lightning safety as the storm passes through your area. Besides the very large hail, the destructive hail potentially with this, keep in mind you still want to stay away from windows as well as this lightning moves through too. But again, this storm, it's been fairly dynamic throughout the day. It's had a lot of low-hanging clouds. It's had a lot of these what we call inflow notches or inflow tails because the storm is rotating. Now, it's not rotating to the point where it's going to produce a tornado, but it has been rotating to the point where it's making some really big hail. And again, that's been the history with this storm. And again, that's exactly what we continue to see here. This is a very dynamic storm here. And again, unfortunately, it has been moving through and producing, again, some of that really large hail. But again, that's great video that we're seeing live with Philip McGee, again, just to the south of Redden, looking directly at that storm. So Philip, again, it looks like this storm is starting to cycle up again. That hail core is getting big again. And go ahead and tell us what you've noticed here really over the last 5 minutes or so as you do continue to look at that storm. So it looks like you're looking off to the north at that storm. Is that correct?
North and northwest, William, and yeah, you're 100% correct on that. As soon as we stopped, we noticed that the storm had really picked up in intensity as far as the cloud-to-ground lightning. We've got to reposition here. We've got to let a vehicle get through here. But yeah, I mean, like you said, very ominous-looking cloud, very scary-looking cloud. And so we're not, you know, we're keeping an eye on this. If we see anything we need to get right back to you with, we'll do that. Back to you, William.
Okay, Philip, while you're repositioning, let's go ahead and go back up to the north again because we have another new severe thunderstorm warning. Where Philip is, that's in southern Oklahoma and southeastern Oklahoma. But again, we do have two severe thunderstorm warnings that do continue up here across parts of northeastern Oklahoma, and a brand new one there. It looks like that's going to be for Okmulgee County. And again, that is going to be until 8:15 this evening. Okmulgee, McIntosh, and also, again, parts of Muskogee County as well. And again, both of these severe thunderstorm warnings up here are in effect until 8:15 this evening. This storm that's basically moving right into the Muskogee area right now, this one has come down in intensity some. This will had a history of producing potentially some quarters. Now it's moving up into Muskogee. The hail core's kind of come down on it just a little bit. But this other storm down here in Okmulgee County now, just to really the east and just kind of to the southeast of the Okmulgee area, that one you can see the hail core really coming up on that again with that bright purple showing up there. So again, brand new severe thunderstorm warning with that right there until 8:15. That also does continue to track off to the northeast. So unfortunately, a lot of these storms are kind of training over the exact same areas, just like we've seen down there in Atoka, where again, they've had two severe storms move through basically within 45 minutes. Tishomingo also had the same thing with some tennis ball size hail, then some quarter size hail move through within about an hour of each other. So again, a lot of these storms have kind of trained over the same area. And again, that's exactly what we're seeing here, as well as that is tracking right up there towards the Muskogee area. But for our friends up there in northeastern Oklahoma, severe thunderstorm warnings there until 8:15 this evening. And then we continue with severe thunderstorm warnings in southern Oklahoma again until 8 p.m. this evening as well, with the storms that are just a little more severe down across this part of the state. Now, again, that's also where Philip McGee is. Let's do this. Let's also take a look across parts of south central Oklahoma for our friends down here. Tishomingo, you folks are actually seeing a heavy thunderstorm, non-severe, but again, a heavy thunderstorm moving back through your area right now. So from Milburn back over through Tishomingo, again, non-severe, but heavy thunderstorm back down through the Medill area, and then also a little bit further to the south down towards Powell. And that right there, that's in Marshall County there across parts of southern Oklahoma. Now, as you get across the Red River into parts of far north Texas, this is a severe storm. So we will be tracking this one here. It's basically, there's the Red River right there. So this one is severe. So we'll be tracking that as it does continue to move up. That may move into Oklahoma and may bring some severe weather as well. So along the Red River, other locations over here from like the Durant area, even back over through Meade, again, heads up, some heavy to potentially severe weather is going to be moving in your area. Now, let's go back to the severe storms that we have here in Oklahoma and southern Oklahoma. And again, like I mentioned, these storms are quite severe. And again, these are the storms that Philip McGee is on. Let's go back to Philip McGee's live stream here. And as we get that pulled back up again, Philip McGee, he's in our exclusive night scope mode. So even though basically the sun is setting, it's getting dark out there, again, with his exclusive night scope mode on the Oklahoma Customs official storm tracking truck, again, we can still see exactly what's going on. And look how electrically active these storms are. That's the first thing you notice there. Again, all those lightning strikes. Again, keep in mind, lightning is very dangerous. But with this storm, we also have some potentially golf ball to maybe tennis ball size hail with this storm here as well. But Philip, go ahead and bring us up to date. You're still south of Redden there. You're looking at this storm. It looks like the hail cores maybe come down just slightly. And in fact, before we bring you on the live line, let me put radar back up here real quick. Let's go and take a look at radar. And again, just to the south of Redden, this hail core here, at least over the last 5 minutes, has definitely come down in intensity, which would be great news because this has really been a big time hail producer, again, with some tennis ball size hail likely throughout the evening. But it has come down, it looks like, fairly significantly, maybe some quarters still possible out of it. And then also this other quite severe storm that's moving through Atoka right now. Again, round two there for Atoka with some quarters possible with that storm there. But Philip, let's go and get you back on the live line. Let's go back to your live stream here and go ahead and tell us what you're seeing there and kind of give us an update of what you've seen there over the last 5 minutes or so.
Okay, well, yeah, we are actually in between the two cells now. We moved a little bit, and Redden is to our north and east, and Tuska is to our south and west. We're definitely in between the two, and that the cell that is there to the north and west of us has really picked up in intensity at this moment. We've got outflow winds going out right now at about 40 miles an hour off of these, and the hail core is going to be directly to our north and east from where we're setting at right now. And that's where our live stream is pointing, is directly off to the north and west. And you can see all of the activity coming off of this storm as it's going to be passing basically to the, again, like I said, to the north and west of Tuska.
Hey, Philip, let me interrupt you. I'm just going to show radar here real quick so everyone kind of knows exactly what you're talking about. So as he's looking off to the northwest, he's talking about these storms over here near the Atoka area, right? So we have been tracking this storm here throughout most of the day, this storm over here now to the south of Redden. This is starting to come down. This is good. This has been a tennis ball size hail producer. So the fact that it's coming down, that is really good. But now Philip is taking a look at this storm over here, most likely quarters with this storm here as it's passing back through Atoka, really about 30 to 45 minutes ago. This storm moved moved over Atoka with tennis ball size hail. So now quarters passing back through Atoka. That's the storm that Philip McGee is looking at. And so let's go and go back to the live line here. We'll switch back to his live stream. I just wanted you guys to see exactly what storm, again, it was that he was talking about. Philip, you're back on the live line.
William. Like I said, we're taking a close look at this storm, and one of the things that kind of caught our attention was the lightning activity that actually picked up in it. And that's basically what we've seen throughout the whole afternoon since we've been down on these storms. You know, they're going to go through, their life cycle stages, they're going to die out, then they're going to build back up. And as long as this warm, moist air is here to support these storms, you know, that's basically what's keeping those hailstones up in those elevated sizes, so up around the tennis ball size. And like you said, that one down here by Crest is probably looking at probably golf ball size, maybe just a touch larger than that. So still damaging hail, and the cloud-to-ground lightning is just ferocious down here. You know, these storms are mean and nasty, and people definitely need to be well aware of them. Back to you.
Yeah, absolutely, Philip. That right there, that's great advice. Really appreciate that update there as well. And again, you're seeing this live, folks, in Phil McGee's exclusive night scope. And again, keep in mind this technology here, it allows us to see storms after dark. You don't see this anywhere else in Oklahoma. You may not really see anywhere else in the country, to be honest with you. But again, even after dark, the sun is setting. And again, we're still able to see exactly what's going on with the cloud features, the cloud structures, which is really important. And of course, all that cloud of ground lightning right there showing up as well. And again, Philip McGee on that storm, basically just to the south of Atoka. And again, that storm continues to be severe. Severe thunderstorm warning continues on that, again, until 8:15 this evening. Now, let's do this. Let's go ahead and switch back to southern Oklahoma, because we do have some brand new severe thunderstorm warnings in effect in southern Oklahoma. The storm I was talking about along the Red River, yes, it is now starting to track into Oklahoma, and it is severe as well. So again, brand new severe thunderstorm warnings down here. That's going to be for Marshall and also for Bryant County down there. And again, severe thunderstorm warning in effect there. That's going to be in effect until, let me just double check that warning there. That's going to be in effect until 8:30 this evening. And they're saying, the Weather Service is saying, some half dollar size hail is going to be possible with that storm. So let's switch radar over. And again, we're talking about far southern Oklahoma, folks. This is the Red River right here. This would be Durant right back over in here. And again, so severe thunderstorm warning, brand new severe thunderstorm warning, again, for Marshall and again, for parts of Bryant County. And again, that's in effect until 8:30. There's Durant right up over in there. We'll zoom this out so you can get a better view of this here momentarily. But again, you can see there's the hail core right there. Half dollar size hail, quite possible, as that again continues to track right up in Oklahoma. The main theme this evening, it really has been the hail. A lot of these storms, if they have been severe, they have been big time hail producers. So as we kind of zoom this out a little bit, again, you can see that's right there along the Red River. And again, that storm continues to track off to the northeast as well. Now for our storms up across parts of northern Oklahoma, let's take a look at those up there, because we do continue with severe thunderstorm warnings up here as well. And again, this is going to be very close to the Muskogee area. The first storm, it's just to really the south of the Muskogee area, really focusing right there, right over Boynton. And again, you can see that hail core right there. And hey, Philip, we're going to actually, let's switch back over to Philip, because he's got something there on his live stream. And again, these storms down there in southern Oklahoma, they've been fairly dynamic. And again, basically, we're seeing another one of those little inflow bands feeding into the storm. A little bit of a mesocyclone, not necessarily a tornado producer, but again, what we're seeing here is just a little bit of that inflow banding coming in, some of that warm, moist air into the storm. So, Philip, let's go and get you back on the live line here. And go ahead, we see your live shot there, and we can see basically the mesocyclone there. That's a great picture, again, with this Nightscope technology, folks. Again, so this evening, as we're saying mesocyclone, we're mainly talking about just a supercell that's producing hail. We're really, there's no imminent tornado risk at all with this storm, but again, you can't actually see the mesocyclone there, and you can't even see where, you know, some warm, moist air is actually feeding into the storm here as well. So let's go and get Philip back on the line here, and again, he'll go ahead and give us an update on that storm. This is the storm just to the south of Atoka. Philip, you're back on the live line with us.
Yeah, William, that's absolutely correct. So like I said on the update, you know, we noticed the lightning picked up on this storm, and normally that's an indicator to us that, you know, these things are starting to intensify. We got down here, we got into position, and lo and behold, that's what we've seen. We kind of seen that little lowering area, you know, with those feeder bands coming into it. And basically, like you had said before, you know, that's basically just food for the storm itself. And so, and that's why those large hail sizes are staying maintained like that. So I'm going to hand it back to you. We're keeping a close eye on this down here, though. You know, there's a lot of scary-looking things that are hanging out in these seas, and that's pretty much typical. But we've got everybody covered, and so back to you.
All right, Philip, appreciate that update that right there. Let's go and switch back over to radar here just real quick so I can show everybody the storm that we're talking about. It's this storm really just to the east of Atoka now. You can see Philip McGee's live GPS. He's right there basically over Tushika looking to the north. There's the storm, quarters to golf balls, maybe plus size hail, again, moving back through the Atoka area right now. And again, like I mentioned, really as we've gone throughout the day, these have been quasi-supercells, meaning that they do have some rotation to them, but the storms that we've had tonight, as opposed to rotation that's going to produce a tornado. The rotation with the storms we've had tonight, it's been very broad. And again, what that does, it actually suspends the hail in the air longer. And as that hail stays in the air longer, it gets bigger and bigger and bigger. And again, that's one of the reasons why we've had such big hail cores really throughout the day. But again, that's exactly what we're seeing with that one right there. And again, Philip McGee's live shot is just perfect. Again, bringing that to us here again with his night scope technology. But Philip, you're still on the live line with us. We're going to switch back over to your live shot here of that storm. And again, go and bring us up to date with what you've seen here over the last several minutes.
Okay, William, we're sitting here, we're keeping an eye on that area that we were concerned about. It's actually started to fall apart a little bit, so that's a good thing. These things are living, breathing beasts, and so they're going to move where that warm, moist air is. They're going to try and stay alive as long as they can. The intensity and the lightning and everything else is actually kind of dropped down, which is a good thing. So that means it's probably going through its cycle stage right now. And so, we're down here. We're keeping a close eye on it. Back to you.
All right, Philip McGee, really appreciate that update that right there from you. So let's go back over to radar here real quick. And as we go and take a look at the overview or kind of the broad view there, especially across parts of southeastern Oklahoma, again, what we're seeing is basically kind of what we've expected this evening. These individual storms are now basically turning into a line along that dry line. And again, that's what we're going to see. We're going to see this kind of turn into one long squall line, so to speak. And again, that's going to continue to track east as we go through the evening. But again, severe thunderstorm warnings continue in southern Oklahoma here until 8:30. That's going to be for Marshall and Bryant County, and then also for Atoka County here as well, and then also for parts of Johnston County. That right there, that's going to be in effect until 8:30. And then we also have other severe thunderstorm warnings up there for Okmulgee County, all the way up through Muskogee County, and locations to the north up there. That's going to be in effect until 8:15. Let's go back on these storms. Let's go and zoom back in on these for our friends up here in northeastern Oklahoma. We don't want to leave you guys out at all. But again, these storms up here, these are quite severe as well. And again, these storms do have the potential at least to produce some quarter-size hail. And again, where you're seeing that dark red going to purple to the north of Boyington there, again, there's going to be an opportunity for some quarters with that cell right there. And then also just to the north, this is going to be up here in actually Wagner County. There's Coweta, there's Wagner right there, just to the north of OK. Hail core right there. And again, some quarters quite likely just on the eastern sides of Wagner. All this activity does continue to track off to the northeast. And for our friends there in Muskogee, you guys have just kind of gotten clipped by both of these. The actual core of both of those storms has actually stayed just to the north and just to the west of the Muskogee area. But again, those are basically training right directly behind each other and again, tracking off to the northeast. So let's go ahead and let's take the overview one more time. We'll check back in with Philip McGee down there in southern Oklahoma. Again, that's where the most severe storms have been this evening is down there in southern Oklahoma. But I do want to give the overview again here. Severe thunderstorm watch continues here for all the counties in blue. That's until midnight tonight. Severe thunderstorm warnings continue in northern Oklahoma or northeastern Oklahoma until 8:15. Severe thunderstorm warnings until 8:30 for this activity down there across parts of southern Oklahoma, and an opportunity for some half dollar to a near tennis ball size hail rather possible with this activity down here across parts of southern Oklahoma. So let's go and zoom back into that activity in southern Oklahoma. We'll take a closer look at that. Then we'll also check back in with lead storm tracker Philip McGee, who's on that activity down there. And again, we'll check back in with him rather here momentarily. But let's switch the radar over. And again, as we do that, again, we can take a look at the overview. Let's zoom this in a little bit closer to Atoka. Now, two things I'm noticing here. The first thing is that storm up there near the Redden area, this is the storm that's produced the tennis ball size hail earlier. This storm over here, it has really come down in intensity. There's still a little bit of purple, still a hail producer for sure right there. Maybe even some golf balls still possible, but it has really come down from where it was earlier. So that is good news right there. Now, this storm moving through the Atoka area, probably some quarters to golf balls possible with this right here. Again, it's tracking right back through Atoka. Atoka got hit with this storm up here earlier with some tennis ball size hail that moved through, but now some, again, golf balls quite likely moving through. That's the storm that lead storm tracker Philip McGee has taken a look at. So let's go and switch back over to his live stream. Again, he's in night scope mode right now. And Philip, you're on the live line. Go ahead and tell us where you are now. I see you're moving, and give us an update with what's happening down there.
Yeah, we repositioned just a little bit. We're actually just to the north and west of Bruno, looking back at that sail. Again, you know, this has kind of been the whole entire thing throughout this afternoon. They're going to go through these recycle stages. Again, we've noticed that, you know, the lightning has definitely picked up in intensity. And so that means one thing. That means that, you know, it's starting to build up again. So hail score is still pretty decent on that one, probably golf ball size for sure. The cloud-to-ground lightning is definitely something. The winds aren't too bad down here right now, and the rain itself has been fairly moderate. And so haven't experienced any kind of roadway ponding or anything at the moment. But we're repositioning right now to get a better look at this thing back to the north and west of us. Back to you, William.
Okay, Philip, appreciate that update. Just while you were talking there, it looks like there's a brand new severe thunderstorm warning coming out from the National Weather Service up there in Tulsa. That's going to be for that cell we looked at just a minute ago. Let's go and switch the radar around here. That's going to be for that cell up there near the Wagner area. So I'm going to zoom the radar out, and we'll kind of slowly pull it up there. That way you can kind of geographically see where it is. I know when we pull the radar around, we cover the entire state, so sometimes when we move the radar all around, sometimes if it's a part of the state you're not as familiar with, sometimes it can be a little confusing. But this is the brand new severe thunderstorm warning up here, and it's going to actually be for this second cell here. And again, this is going to be until 8:30. And again, that's going to be for some quarter size hail and an opportunity for some 70 mile per hour winds. But it's going to be this storm here. So basically both of these storms now, severe thunderstorm warning, this storm right here, severe thunderstorm warning until 8:30. This storm right here, severe thunderstorm warning until 8:15 this evening. But again, both of these could potentially be producing some quarter size hail and again, wind 70 miles per hour plus possible. Now these storms, the way it looks right now, they're going to stay just to the north and just to the west of the Muskogee area. They continue to track off to the northeast right there. But again, every basically storm we've had tonight that has been severe, they have been hailers, they have been hail producers. And again, we've had confirmed hail reports. These aren't necessarily radar estimated reports. These storms have been producing hail. So you definitely have to take these seriously. And again, also these storms are very electrically active. You see all the cloud to ground lightning strikes showing up there as well. So definitely keep that in mind, folks. If you're in the path of these storms here, you know, you definitely want to stay away from the windows, go to an interior part of your house, and again, definitely ride these storms out, especially in southern Oklahoma where we've had the larger hail. When we're talking about tennis ball size hail down there, that will blow out some windows. So again, definitely keep that in mind. But again, that larger hail has been confined to parts of southern Oklahoma. So let's go and zoom the radar out. We'll take it back down to the south. This storm here, let's go and zoom in on this. This one's not severe, but it is coming up in intensity quite quickly here. And this one is going to be just really to the west of Eufaula there, and also very close to the Crowder area. This is a heavy thunderstorm. Lake Eufaula will be right back up over in here. But again, this storm has come up in intensity, a little bit of a developing hail core there as well. Dime-sized hail probably likely with this storm right now. But again, this one could be trying to go severe here fairly quickly as well. But from Eufaula back down towards Crowder, again, heads up, this is a heavy thunderstorm. Hail likely with it, and again, a lot of cloud to ground lightning there as well. But again, that's the one storm in the state currently that is not severe. But for our friends in that part of the state, again, heads up, it is still quite heavy. It is just below severe limits there. Now, the storms back down here in southern Oklahoma, let's go and zoom in on those. And we'll go and take a look at this. This is a storm that Philip McGee has been on really throughout the evening. Again, that storm basically now to the northeast of Redden. That one, it's cycling up slightly. It had come down a little bit more, but this one here, this is a storm that had actually produced some tennis ball size hail earlier, right over Tishomingo, and then also over Atoka earlier this evening. So this one has been a big time hail producer. Philip McGee has been tracking that one for most of the evening, and now the storm directly behind it that is basically just now moved through Atoka. They've had two rounds of severe weather this evening. This other storm that just now moved through Atoka, again, this one down here is still probably producing some quarters to golf balls. You can see Philip McGee's live GPS location there. He's looking at that storm. We're going to talk to him. We're going to check his live stream momentarily on that. But also, I want to take a look at this storm down here in southern Oklahoma along the Red River. It's a brand new severe thunderstorm down there. Fairly intense down here as well. Let's go and take a look at this. Again, this is in far southern Oklahoma. It's down there in parts of Marshall County. Let's go and zoom in on this here just a little bit closer. And as we do that, again, you can see that hell core there, just to the south of Kingston there. And again, this continues to track off to the northeast as well. Here's Durant over here. So in reality, this storm is going to track directly into or just to the north of Durant. So again, heads up down there in southern Oklahoma. This is a strong storm. Half dollar size hail is quite likely with this storm. Again, you can see these big hail cores that we've had tonight. They're not small or compact, but these are big, wide hail cores. And again, this storm has the exact same features as it's tracked out of North Texas now into far southern Oklahoma. There's the Red River. It's crossed the Red River now in Oklahoma. And again, that severe thunderstorm warning there continues until 8:30 this evening. 70 mile per hour winds likely with it. And again, half dollar size hail, a big swath of half dollar size hail likely, again, tracking up towards the Durant area there. Now let's go back over to Philip McGee. Let's go back to this storm there in southern Oklahoma. We'll take a look at his live stream and again get the very latest update from him as to what's going on. And Philip, as we switch back over to your live stream, go ahead and tell us where you are now and go and tell us what you've seen here over the last few minutes.
Okay, William, yeah, we pulled off. We're still kind of to the west of Bruno, and we're looking back to that cell that's to the north and west of us. So it's going to be basically moving across just north of Atoka right now, and that's the one that you were just referring to. That probably still has the golf ball size hail and everything. Rain has kind of died down a little bit. As a matter of fact, as we're setting here, we're starting to see some pea-sized hail fall right now. It's actually dropping hail out, and we're quite a ways away from that storm, to be honest with you. And so we're going to move the camera and see if we can't catch some of that as it's coming through. So you should see that on the live stream here in just a second, some of that hail hitting the ground in front of us.
Okay, Philip McGee, appreciate that update. While you were talking there, we're going to break away from you for just 1 second because we have brand new severe thunderstorm warnings now across parts of northern Oklahoma and northeastern Oklahoma. Let me go and switch the radar here. We're going to get right back to your live stream there and exactly what's going on there. But let's go up here to far northeastern Oklahoma, and this is a brand new severe thunderstorm warning up here. And it's going to be for this cell right here. But this is going to be for Mays, Delaware, Cherokee, and Wagner County until 8:30 this evening. And it's going to be have an opportunity for some quarter-size hail. And again, this storm, it's moving quickly to the northeast at almost 60 miles per hour. But again, this is a brand new severe thunderstorm warning up here. Locust Grove down through Pegs. Again, this is far northeastern Oklahoma, but again, heads up, as again, this does continue to track off to the northeast. There's Jay, and again, it will eventually track out of Oklahoma into parts of Arkansas. But again, this is another hailer, again, an opportunity for it to produce some quarter-size hail. That's really been the theme this evening. Again, quarters to half dollars to earlier in the evening, we even had some tennis ball-size hail. But again, most of these storms tonight have been hail producers. Again, so definitely keep that in mind. And again, quite a bit of cloud of ground lightning associated with these storms as well. Definitely go to an interior room of your house if you're riding these out. And again, make sure you're staying away from the windows as well, as again, they're producing hail and also producing that very dangerous lightning as well. So let's go and zoom the radar out here a little bit more. And again, let's go and kind of take an overview just for the fact we have so much going on here. And again, multiple severe thunderstorm warnings really across Oklahoma right now. So as we zoom this out, I'll pull it down just a little bit there, try and squeeze all this in here. But again, from northeastern Oklahoma all the way down to southern Oklahoma, again, you can see multiple severe thunderstorm warnings currently in effect. You can see our team of trackers, their live GPS locations. Some in western Oklahoma still tracking some of that blowing dust out there in western Oklahoma, and then some here in eastern Oklahoma tracking the severe weather this evening as well. But again, multiple now severe thunderstorm warnings across parts of eastern Oklahoma. And that's basically exactly what we anticipated as we've kind of been monitoring the conditions throughout the day. And again, that severe thunderstorm watch is in effect until midnight as well. And again, so things are kind of playing out exactly the way we expected it. But overall, this is going to turn into a line as we head into the evening. And again, that is going to track into parts of Arkansas as we head into the overnight period. Now let's go back to that storm down there in southern Oklahoma. This is Philip McGee's live shot there. Again, he's still just to the south of Atoka. And Philip, it looks like you're in quite a bit of rain there. Any hail mixing in with the location that you're at right now?
Yeah, briefly there for just a second, William, there was pea-sized hail that was coming down, but now it's basically turned back to rain, which is a good thing. You know, they're at Atoka, they've gone 2 rounds of probably damaging hail, and they don't need anything else over there, that's for sure. So we've got an eye on it. Main thing right now that we're seeing is a heavier rain moving through now, and that cloud to ground line. So back to you.
Okay, Philip, appreciate that live update there and your live shot there. Let's go and switch back over to radar. We'll take a look at the exact cell that, again, Philip is talking about. So we're going to zoom in here to parts of southeastern Oklahoma. And, again, you can see basically now really just to the east of Atoka, basically focusing back up over there near the Singleton area. Again, some fairly heavy rain. But overall, the intensity with that activity there, this is good, has actually started to come back down. So that's good because, again, those storms were quite mean earlier this evening. And, again, they were producing some tennis ball size hail earlier. Again, the one storm there just to the east of the Redden area, that one has actually come back up in intensity just slightly. It's this storm right over here that we're talking about, right here with the pink showing up. So again, a little bit of a redevelopment of the hail core there. That storm, it's been hanging around this evening. So this storm actually started near the Tishomingo area over across parts of south central Oklahoma earlier, again with some really some tennis ball size hail. It's continued to track northeast throughout the evening with a history of producing again hail throughout the evening. It kind of cycles up and cycles down, but it looks like it's kind of starting to cycle back up. But again, severe thunderstorm warnings do continue on it. But again, the storm basically now just to the east of Atoka there, it's actually come down in intensity slightly, so that would be good news. And then again, we have a heavier thunderstorm back behind that. That again is not severe currently. So good news there with the non-severe weather. Let's take a look across parts of far southern Oklahoma down along the Red River, because again, we do continue with this severe thunderstorm warning down here until 8:30 as well. And again, this is gonna be for parts of Marshall and Bryant County. And again, for our friends down here in Durant, this storm is basically tracking right up into the Durant area. Here's Durant over here. And again, you can see this hail core here. We're seeing the purple right there. Quarters, half dollars, probably likely with this cell right here, as it does continue to track off to the northeast. And also an opportunity for some 70 mile per hour winds with that storm as well. It's very quickly tracking off to the northeast at 50 miles per hour. Josh Holcomb, one of our storm trackers, now coming into position on this storm here as well. So that's where we are right now, folks. Let's go and take a look at the overview here one more time. We've been on live here for just about an hour, so we're going to take a quick break. But let's go and take a look at the overview here. And as we take a look at that, again, you can see severe thunderstorm watch for all of eastern Oklahoma. That's in effect until midnight tonight. And then again, these multiple severe thunderstorm warnings, as we basically have a squall line of activity now developing that will continue to track east as we go through the evening. Now, we're going to have another live update coming up here in about 15 minutes. We're just going to take a quick break because we've been on the air live here for about an hour. So again, we'll be back here in 15 minutes. Keep it here with Oklahoma Weather Tracker TV. We'll keep you up to date with the latest live weather information for Oklahoma.